Hello, Grinding Garys. On this video, I wanted to briefly talk about just the grind in EDF. I've always loved the grind in the past games. It always took a long time to complete the game 100%, having to beat every mission on every difficulty, and then trying to get all the weapons as well. I've always personally loved that, and it gave me a reason to keep playing, and I wanted to address that on EDF 5, how they've changed it, and have they changed it for the better. Let me go ahead and start up my game save here. As you can see, I have 432 hours on this save and 56 hours on this save. That was for the Let's Play, by the way. Let's take a look at my weapons here. Let's go ahead and start up here. So I have not really grinded for weapons too much. I've mainly been trying to grind weapons to increase their levels. But as far as my completion, where is my completion at? Here it is. Right now I have 1,091 weapons, and there's 1,092 weapons in the game. So I'm assuming I'm missing a low-level weapon somewhere, level 0 or something. But, so there is a lot of weapons to collect in this game still, so that's a good. There's a lot of grind, but I would say it's actually easier this time around to get all the weapons. Because of the fact that they made a change, and that change is, when you're playing the game, playing missions, you'll notice that there's a tighter spread of weapons this time around. So for example, you'll see like on certain missions, on a certain difficulty, you'll see level 40 weapons through like 55, somewhere around like 10 to 15 level weapon spread. So say for example, if you are trying to find a certain weapon or trying to level up a certain weapon, you can play a certain mission you know will drop just in that area of range of weapons, and it's a lot easier to find that weapon you're missing or to find an upgrade for that weapon. However, having played this game close to 500 hours already, as you can see, my weapons, the stars there next to the stats, they're not hardly any of them are maxed out. And this is a fully maxed out weapon. You'll see a star up in the actual name of the title of the weapon. You'll see a star next to it when you know it's fully maxed out. But I think this is another genius decision that they made. The first one being the change to the Fencer class. I think it was very smart of how they handled it, and I'm very happy. But this is another genius decision, and that is, I'm still playing, you know, 400, 500 hours into the game, and I'm still looking forward to weapon drops. So, and there's been times where I actually just been particularly trying to grind higher level weapons to get them maxed out, and even so, it takes a long time to do so. So, in a way, people could maybe look at that and see that's a negative thing, but I think it gives people incentive who want to play this game a lot, reason to keep playing and excited about new weapon drops. And I think that was very, very smart of them. And like I said in previous videos, the upgrades are very substantial. They're very noticeable. It's not just, you know, small 5-point increase in damage. It's actually substantial damage increases, substantial reload increases, and range and accuracy increases. So for the people who are just wanting to play the game through once, they can play through on normal or hard, and they'll have the damage that they need to finish that difficulty. But if you want to beat on Hardest and Inferno, and have your map, you're probably going to want to grind out some more weapons to get your weapons leveled up. And on top of that, it still gives people that have a lot of hours in the game still a reason to play and excited about seeing weapon drops. So I think they did a perfect job on this game, and I'm very happy, and I hope that they continue this trend in the future. Because I've always liked the grind in the games, and this, it's no longer just a grind about completing your percentage, which it still is, but it's also a grind about maxing out all your weapons and all your vehicles. So very exciting. And also, as I mentioned in a previous video, I believe, when you actually play a mission, if you play on hard, normal, or easy, pretty much if you play on hard, you will get credit for normal and easy. If you play on normal, you get credit for normal and easy. So what they're trying to do is they reduce you, so people that want to play on hard and then move on to Hardest and Infernal, they don't have to go back through and play on normal and easy. You get credit for that. But now if you want to beat Hardest or Inferno, you have to beat each mission separately on each class for Hardest and Inferno. So say, for example, if you play on Inferno, you're not going to get credit for Hardest as well. So there's still a grind for the people that want to, you know, get that 100% completion, which is always impressive in EDF games. And it's still the same thing where once you get 70% of the missions complete, you get your weapons or your armor and your weapons unlocked. So, but now there's actually limits on Inferno as well online, so that's kind of cool. I like that. But anyway, so I think, like I said, they handled this very well. I'm very happy with the grind in this game, and I'm still looking forward to weapons. Still looking forward to weapon drops, and I think I made a estimate of thinking that you take about 5 or 6 weapon drops to max out your levels. Well, I was definitely wrong on that. It probably closer to, I don't know, 15, 20 maybe. It really depends on the mission you're playing, because it's all about the quality of the weapon drop. Like I've had in the past games, past missions I've played, I'll get this weapon, say this exact weapon drop, but it won't be a higher quality version than what I have. So it's not guaranteed that when you get this weapon again, you get a better version. It's just you have a chance of getting a better version. And if it's a certain stat that's better than what you have, then you get credit for that stat, and that stat will go up. But you won't necessarily always get the exact weapon that you need. So I'm imagining higher level weapons will be harder to upgrade max, but I have a few weapons that are maxed out. Let me look at the Ranger here again really quick. I do have some higher level weapons that are maxed out. Let's see. Like this one is almost maxed out. This one's almost maxed out. This one is maxed out, and it's 84. So I don't think it's not like ridiculously impossible to upgrade your weapons fully, the higher level ones, but it is definitely more challenging. So I definitely like that. So it's definitely cool. Like I maxed out the best AF-100, and this one's almost maxed out. So it's not impossible. So that's encouraging. Also, I finally figured out what that plus stat next to the star is. Like for example, I've had weapons. Let me see if I can find one really quick. Where it's like a solid star, but it has a plus next to it. And I've always wondered, why in the world is there a plus? And I don't know if I can, oh, here we go. The six star is solid, but it has a plus next to it. The only thing that, at least what I'm guessing, I'm pretty sure is what this is what that means is, if there's a plus next to it, that means that there's two stats involved on that single column. For example, you can see there's 203.8 is the damage, and then times 2 rockets. So what that means is, I'm assuming the 203.8 can still go up, but the X2 is maxed out. So it just means that there's two stats there, and one of them's maxed out, the other one is not. So that's the best thing that I can understand. Let's see if I can find another one really quick. That's not, you know, an easy one to figure out. I thought I saw one there. Nope. Here's another one. Yeah, where it's 45.3 times 50. The X50 is maxed out, but the 45.3 is not maxed out. Like in shotguns is definitely an example where you'll see that, where you'll see like the damage is maxed out, but the X15, for example, isn't, or the vice versa. Like this one right here, 224.2 X11. So I don't know if the 11 is going to go up or the 224, but that, I'm pretty sure that's what that means. But anyway, that's pretty much all I wanted to talk about. Just I'm so happy with the change they made for the grind in this game. So very encouraging. So that's all I want to talk about. Once again, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you on the next video.